once upon a future time in a place called Stardust Bay. Counting down to adventure now. Rockets on a mission, we're on our way. Space racers, surfing the solar winds. Space racers, together the fun begins. Way out where the planets, moons, and stars all shimmer, shine, shine. Having a great time exploring space racers.
Hey, wait for me!
Cadets, I am conducting a study and need you to collect samples of soil from the moon's surface. I would perform the task myself, but I have something else to attend to.
Consider it done, Headmaster Crane.
Good morning, cadets. Would you mind replacing a couple of large solar panels up in space? I'd do it myself, but I'm way too busy today.
We'd be happy to help, Coot.
Wait up, guys. I just got some brand new speedometers to measure your pace during races. Can you test them by flying from Earth to the moon and back as fast as possible?
We're on it, Coach.
Thanks. There's something else I gotta do right away.
Was way too much work for one day. I think I'll power down and sleep for a whole year.
I can't sleep that long. I get hungry.
Let's go tell everyone that we completed our assignments.
Swift starlight. Cross the finish.
I couldn't talk to Headmaster Crane. He was too busy meditating.
Coot was playing catch.
Coach Pigeon was sleeping. I can't believe this. The adults have it so easy compared to us.
Eagle, I'm sure they had good reasons for what they were doing.
How's this for a reason? If they get us to do their work, they don't have to.
That's true. We do all the hard work around here.
And it's not fair. I say we tell them how we feel, right now.
I don't think that's a good idea.
Sure it is. Whose side are you on, Robyn?
If we're gonna talk to the adults, we have to do it together.
Sorry, but count me out. I think it's just as hard to be an adult.
Then you're not one of us.
We'll do it without you. Come on, guys. Let's go.
Can't we just take a nap first?
I understand your point of view.
You do?
Yes. If you really believe that we have an easier life than students, I would like to make you a proposal. I will allow each of you to take the place of an adult for one day. At the end of the day, you will no doubt feel relaxed and refreshed. And then you can return to your very difficult lives as students with new energy.
Really? We get to act like grown-ups for a whole day? Awesome!
Wait! Are adults still allowed to watch Captain Cosmos?
I thought I'd have to wait forever for this day. This is gonna be sweet!
Just remember what a wise rocket once said. An acorn cannot become a tree in a single day.
What did he mean by that?
No clue. I think I should do Headmaster Crane's job. After all, I'm the most natural leader.
If by leader you mean the bossiest, then yeah, you're the leader.
I call Coot! I call Coot! All I gotta remember is the right tool for the right job.
I'm gonna take Coach Pigeon's place. If there's anyone who can teach young rockets about flying, it's me.
Yeah, I can't wait for tomorrow. It's gonna be one fun and easy day.
Good morning, students. I am Headmaster Eagle. I will be your guide as we explore the stars and observe the wonders of our galaxy.
That's funny, Eagle.
Now do Coot's voice.
Do Coach Pigeon.
As I was saying, today we'll study some of the constellations. Let's start by looking at Aquarius. Yes, Junior Cadet?
Why is Aquarius in one part of the sky in that image, but it's in another part of the sky in that one?
That's a very good question. And the answer is very simple. The reason is... The real question is, what do you think?
Well, I think you don't know the answer.
Your question requires further thought. I'll be right back. Yoinks! Okay, if I just concentrate, the answer will appear in my mind. That's how Headmaster Crane does it. Come on, Eagle, think. Why do constellations change position? Constellations, stars, the cosmos, Captain Cosmos. No, that's not right. Start again. Stars, planets, orbs, Orbo. The big Orbo match next week. Oh, this is so hard.
So, what's the answer?
As a wise rocket once said, only when we know what we know do we know the answer to what we don't know. Or something like that.
That makes no sense!
We want Headmaster Crane.
We want Crane! We want Crane! We want Crane! We want Crane!
Let's see. I think this is the bracket ratchet. Or is it the racket bratchet?
Oh, you won't be needing any of those today, Hawk. I want you to continue testing my new stub bot. I designed this bot to catch small meteorites before they hit any of our satellites or space stations. Those pesky little rocks can cause a lot of damage. Now, throw that ball at the bot. Good. Now, come over to my computer and type in what you just did.
I threw the ball. The stop bot caught the ball.
Fine. Now, keep this up for the rest of the day. Protecting our space stations and satellites is serious business.
Coot, wait! What about the right tool for the right job?
Okay, cadets. I'm Coach Raven, and today is your lucky day. I'm going to teach you how to avoid space debris while flying at a high speed. We'll be using the obstacle course, but before you start, I'm going to give you a little demonstration of the right way to do it. Now, I don't expect you to have my superior flying skills. Just do the best you can. Ready? Go! Watch out! Hey, no! Look out! Starling, not that way! Oh, man. This job is exhausting. I could use a little...
nap right about
now. What? Who's there?
Raven, this is Eagle. I need to see you right away. It's urgent.
I'll be right there. Now I know why Coach Pigeon was sleeping.
I've changed my mind. You should be Headmaster, Raven. Everybody looks up to you.
Really? I can't think of anybody.
I'd rather switch places with Hawk. He's got the easy job, playing catch all day.
Eagle has it easy. All he does is meditate. He could take a nap and nobody would know it.
Raven's the one who has it easy. Think about it. He's teaching rockets how to fly.
Oh, yeah. Well, there's a lot more to it than that.
Is there a problem, guys?
A problem? Are you kidding? We're doing great.
Cool. So I guess you'll each have something wonderful to tell the adults when they ask you for a report on your activities.
Okay, fine. There's a problem.
Ha! Come on, admit it now. The life of an adult rocket is just as hard as the life of a cadet.
Yeah.
Okay, you're right. We admit it.
Good. Now, let's do some damage control. You're a great flyer, Raven, but you were trying to turn them into little ravens in one lesson.
You're right. First, they have to get used to flying through the obstacle course slowly, and then they can speed it up little by little. Good job, cadets.
We both know that Coot likes to do things the old-fashioned way. It works for him. But there are other ways to do this job.
Right. That's why using Coot's little helper bot is a great idea. Okay, Dinky, toss that ball! And there are easier ways to collect data. Ava, report!
A ball weighing 2.1 ounces traveled at a speed of 63.5 miles per hour. The ball was caught.
Response time was 0.89 seconds.
Wow. I was just going to say the exact same thing.
This isn't going to work, Robyn. I'm a boring teacher. I can't even answer a simple question.
Sure you can. You were in the same class as me when we learned all about constellations. How would Eagle answer a question about the stars?
I got it! We used to think that the Earth stood still, and the stars moved all around it. Okay, constellations, start moving!
I'm Taurus.
I'm Gemini!
I'm Aquarius.
But then, we figured out that the Earth moved too.
Woohoo! I'm Earth!
And when you're watching from Earth, the stars that are closest seem to move faster, while the stars that are farther away seem to move more slowly.
So that's why Aquarius was in a different part of the sky.
Exactly. Everything in the galaxy moves, including the sun.
We're sorry we said you weren't one of us, Robyn.
Not only are you one of us,
you're probably the best one.
Nice job today, cadets.
I think you're ready to take over the academy.
Thanks, but we're not ready yet to do this again. Turns out it's just as hard to be an adult rocket. Do you think they'll ever know what really happened?
Not if we don't tell them. I'm for keeping this day a secret.
Me too.
The headmaster's never gonna know how I almost messed up. Not if I can help it.
Congratulations, cadets, on your successful day as adult rockets.
Thanks. It's easy to succeed when you know what you're doing.
Perhaps. But as a wise rocket once said, only when we know what we know do we know the answer to what we don't know. Or something like that.